Hi guys, welcome to my channel Patantrache Yukta means learning tricks. So today we will going to discuss about Porter Governor numerical. So this is a type 2 numerical. I had already explained you the type 1 numerical in previous video. If you refer this video, you can understand this numerical easily. So let's start. What is given in this numerical? So everything is the numerical is same. So 250 mm long. This is nothing but the length of the arm. This is upper arm, this is lower arm. The length of the arm is 250 mm. Then after that, what is given? Pivoted the links of 40 mm and 50 mm. Means this is statement. What is that mean? Means upper arm is 40 mm away from the axis of rotation, and the lower arm is 50 mm away from the axis of rotation. Then what is given? Then what is given? The length, mass of the ball. Mass of the ball is 5 kg. Then mass of the sleeve is 50 kg. Friction. This is important in this numerical. Friction is given, and the value of friction is 40 Newton. So determine the range of friction. If radius of rotation is 125 and 150. So there are two cases. So this is nothing but the given data. So let's start the numerical now. I will start the solution now. You refer this diagram as well. So let's start the solution. Okay, solution. As you know, in the previous video we use Pythagoras theorem for finding h1, but in this numerical we cannot use the Pythagoras theorem. So another method to find the h1 is tan alpha is equals to r upon h1. So how we will get this? If you use the tan function in this triangle, so triangle name is BFA. So tan function is what? Opposite upon adjacent. So opposite side is BF and adjacent side is AF. So this is nothing but the R, so radius of rotation, and this is nothing but the h, so h1. So we know the tan, we don't know the alpha. So first we will find the alpha. So how we will find alpha in triangle, in this triangle BFA, in triangle BFA we will use sine function first. Sine alpha, it is equals to opposite upon hypotenuse. So opposite upon hypotenuse, so what is the opposite side is BF upon AB. Okay, this is AB, this is hypotenuse. So BF is nothing but this is 125, BG minus FG. So 125 minus 40, nothing but BF. So 125 minus 40 upon AB. So AB is nothing but 250. So we will get answer 0.34. And if you have to find alpha, so sine inverse of 0.34, then alpha is equals to 19.88 degree. Now so we successfully find the alpha. So now tan alpha is equals to what? Tan alpha value is 19.88, then value of tan alpha is nothing but 0.3616. okay, after finding tan alpha we have to find h1. So first step is find h1. Okay, so tan alpha is equals to r upon h1. So r is nothing but the radius of rotation. So what is the value of radius of rotation? 125. We know the value of tan alpha, so easily we can find the value of h1. So let's write all these values. 3616, it is equals to r. So what is the value of r? 125 upon h1. So value of h1 is equals to 345.68 mm. Okay, this is the value of h1. So first step in this numerical is to find h1. Okay, so after finding h1, now we know that q is equals to tan alpha, tan beta upon tan alpha. So tan alpha we know that. Now we have to find tan beta. So same procedure we will continue in which triangle? Now in this triangle BEC. So now in triangle BEC, okay, we will use sine function first. So sine beta, what is opposite side? BE upon opposite upon hypotenuse means BE upon BC. BE upon BC. So how we will find BE? BG minus GE. So what is the length of BG? GE 50. So 125 minus 50. 125 minus 50 upon BC. So length of BC is 250. Okay. So we will get answer like 0.3, and beta is equals to sine inverse of 0.3. Then we will get beta is equals to 17.45 degree. Okay, 17.45 degree, and then tan beta is equals to 0.3143. Okay, then after this we can easily find the value of Q, tan beta upon tan alpha. Okay, so tan beta is nothing but 0.3143 upon tan alpha. We have find what is the value of tan alpha. 0.3616. So Q is equals to 0.8692. Okay, 0.8692. This is the 0.8692. This is the value of Q. Okay, now till now we have find value of Q and height. So now we will write the formula. So what is the formula? Omega 1 square, it is equals to G by H. Okay, G by H in bracket 1 plus capital M upon 2M. But in this case friction is also given, so we will multiply both the side by G, multiply and divide by, then plus or minus F into in bracket Q plus 1. This is the whole formula for this numerical, second type numerical. So this is a note. If sleeve going down, then F is negative. Okay, if sleeve is going down, then friction is negative. So in this case, in first case, as the sleeve going down, the speed of the governor decreases. So in this case we will take friction as negative. So let's quickly write down all these value. We have to find omega 1 square. G is nothing but 9.81. so what is the value of H? We have find the value of H. What is the value of H? We can see from this, what is the value of 345.68? This is the value of H1, 345.68. So let's write immediately 345.68. okay, then 1 plus, what is the value of capital M? Is mass of sleeve, and this is nothing but the mass of ball. So mass of sleeve is 50 kg, and G is 9.81, and friction value is 40, which is given. So as I said minus 40. Why minus 40? Refer this note. Okay, then 2 into M. So what is the value of mass of the ball? Is nothing but the 5. So mass of ball is 5 into G, that is 9.81. okay, into Q plus 1. So what is the value of Q? 0.8692 plus 1. So after calculating all this value, you will get omega 1 is nothing but 17.22 radian per second. Okay, so we know that omega 1 can be written as 2 pi n1 by 60. So now we have to find n1. We know all these values. So n1 is equals to omega 1 into 60 divided by 2 pi. So 17.22 into 60 divided by 2 into 3.14. okay, so we will get the value of n1, 164.44 rotation per minute. So similarly you can find the value of n2. So value of n2, I will give you the answer. What is the value of n2? 188.12 rotation per minute. Okay, then subtracting n2 minus n1, so you will get the answer, which is nothing but 23.68 rotation per minute. So this is nothing but the range of the speed of the governor, 23.68 rotation per minute. So this is the diagram for case 1. So I will just show you the diagram for case 2. So slight change in the case 2 is this, the radius of rotation is 150 mm, and this is a diagram. So what we have to do, first we have to find h1 by using sine function in this triangle, then we will find h1, then we have to find tan beta, tan alpha, tan beta for q, find q. So in this triangle also use sine function. So same procedure we have to find for case 2 as well. The only change is this 150. Okay, so 150 minus 40, previous case what we have done, 125 minus 40. So this is the only change. So you can easily find the value of n2 as well. So I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.